this video, I will be performing sensitivity analysis on this payoff table manually and in Excel. In essence, I'll be showing the effect of changing the probabilities on the expected values. With the current probabilities, the expected value of D1 is 28, and for D2, the expected value is 31. Now, we want to examine how changing the probability values impacts the expected values, and hence the decisions. Let's first determine a probability P for S1 that will make us indifferent between D1 and D2. The probability for S2 will thus be 1 minus P, since we have only two states of nature here. For D1, the expected value is calculated to be 34P plus 19 times 1 minus P, which gives 15P plus 19. And for D2, the expected value is 45P plus 10 times 1 minus P, which simplifies to 35P plus 10. If the decision maker is indifferent between D1 and D2, then the expected value of D1 should be equal to the expected value of D2. On solving for P, we have 9 equals 20P, so that P equals 0.45. That is, when the probabilities of the states of nature are 0.45 for S1 and 0.55 for S2, the expected values are equal to 25.75 for both D1 and D2. That is, the decision maker is indifferent between choosing D1 and D2 when P equals 0.45. We can view the sensitivity ranges graphically as follows. For D1, when P equals 0, the expected value is 19. And when P equals 1, the expected value is 34. And that's the line in blue. Similarly for D2, when P equals 0, the expected value is 10. And when P equals 1, the expected value is 45. And that's the line in red. We see here that as long as P is less than 0.45, the expected value of D1 is higher than that of D2. So D1 would be the preferred alternative in that interval, assuming payoffs are profits. And when P is greater than 0.45, the expected value of D2 is higher than that of D1, and the preferred alternative there is D2. Now, suppose there is a third decision alternative, D3, with a constant payoff of 22 under both states of nature. Then the expected value of D3 will be 22, represented by this horizontal line in green. Now, D3 will be the preferred alternative if P is less than 0.2. At P equals 0.2, the decision maker will be indifferent between D1 and D3. Between P equals 0.2 and P equals 0.45, D1 will be the preferred alternative, and D2 will be preferred when P is greater than 0.45. We can generate these results using data table in Excel as follows. Suppose we use the same probabilities from the initial payoff table. That is, P equals 0.6 for S1, and I'm going to use 1 minus P for S2. For the expected values, I'll use equal sum product, select the payoffs for D1, comma, then select the probabilities. I'm going to press F4 on PC to lock down the probabilities, and enter. Then grab the handle and drag down for D2 and D3. I'm going to place P here, skip a row, type 0, then 0.1. Select both and drag all the way to 1. I'm going to type EVD1 here, drag to the right for D2 and D3. I'm going to highlight these cells yellow for the expected values. Equals the expected value of D1, equal EV for D2, equal EV for D3. Next, to use the data table, I'm going to select the probabilities and the expected values. Click the Data tab, then What If Analysis. Then click Data Table. Now, the expected values depend on the probabilities, so we need to select the probability cell. Since the probabilities are arranged in a column, we will enter the value of P into the column input cell and click OK. To generate the graph, I'm going to select the probabilities together with the expected values. Hold the Ctrl key and select the titles. Then click Insert, Scatter, I can choose the one with markers if I want, but I will select this one without markers. And that's the sensitivity chart. Thanks for watching.